Hello, everyone, and welcome to your Inner Journey weather report for the week of March 14th through March 20th, 2021, in which we utilize archetypal astrology to help understand the energies in the collective and how they will contribute to your inner journeys this week, whether they be psychedelic journeys, vision quests, meditation intensives, yoga retreats, dream analysis, whatever it may be. So let's look at our weather, our archetypal astrology weather forecast for this week. Okay, here we are with Archetypal Explorer. And this week we're building towards a Sun conjunct Venus. And Sun conjunct Venus is actually a wonderful energy when it comes to inner journeys, because the Sun has to do with our sense of self, our energy level, and our kind of life mission. And Venus has to do with the archetype of pleasure, the archetype of harmony, the archetype of camaraderie and joy and relaxation. And so Sun conjunct Venus is a time often of feeling kind of a holiday quality, a sense that our life mission, our identity gets linked up with this more pleasure side of life, the Venusian side of life, enjoying the beauty, enjoying the friends. These are all Venusian things: beauty, art, friends, music. So that type of inner journey may be something that involves music and maybe actually socializing. So we're saying inner journey here, but you know, there's something to actually, you know, we can still be in a significant inner journey experience, but actually be connecting with others. And so that's a wonderful transit. It's soft. And in order to understand it better, we can look at people that were born with that alignment in their birth chart, that combination. To understand it better, Leonardo DiCaprio was born with that combination. And if you look at his movies, actually, I can't think of any other actor in Hollywood who has more scenes in movies of socializing at parties. Romeo and Juliet, The Great Gatsby, Wolves of Wall Street, Django Unchained, even Blood Diamond. They all have scenes of parties and socializing and good times and good connections. Sun, Venus. Okay, the challenge there of that transit, all these transits have rewarding side and challenging sides. The challenge can be a sense of laziness, because our sense of purpose and mission, the Sun conjoins with Venus, which is more not about productivity, about enjoyment. Sometimes we can feel lazy, maybe overindulgent, no big issue, especially if we go into it with archetypal mindfulness, astrological mindfulness, and we're aware. We feel that energy and we see it. We say, oh, Sun can join Venus. Let me just enjoy it. Let me just enjoy the ride. Interestingly, another energy that we have building this week is Mercury-Mars alignment. Mercury square Mars, Mercury-Mars alignment. And that one is different. It's a different quality. It's a quality in which Mercury has to do with thinking, communicating, perceiving, speaking, and Mars has to do with forcefulness, bravery. Mars has a brash energy, an assertive energy. And so that combination has more to do with saying bravely, communicating something bravely, communicating something sharply, or thinking in a way that's very active. Mars has to do with athleticism, competition, makes things active. So when it's with Mercury, the mind becomes very active. We can look at people born with that combination to understand it better. Joe Rogan, born with the Mercury-Mars alignment, always speaking in his podcast, always talking, always thinking, always cogitating, always debating, you know, asserting. These are Mercury-Mars things. And so challenges, well, the rewards here with this transit are the ability to speak with bravery, speak your mind. Challenges are that sometimes the mind can become overheated, overactive. Our tendency to want to debate can become aggressive, or maybe we say things too rashly. So again, that archetypal mindfulness, that astrological mindfulness, we want to be aware of these energies as they rise, either within us or in our sphere of experience. Maybe other people are experiencing them that we're witnessing. And we want to know, okay, that's what's happening. I get it. I see you, Mercury and Mars. You know, let's just be present. Let's be very present. Let's allow these energies reveal what they're here to reveal. And they tend to behave, they tend to come together. And another aspect here that is good, another angle that's good on these two aspects we talked about today, Sun, Venus, and Mercury, Mars, is that they're a bit of a anecdote to each other, because Mercury, Mars can be the tendency to declare, that's Mercury, speak war, that's Mars, or declare something very assertive and brave that is challenging, opposing, confronting. Then the Sun Venus, though, Sun Venus is very amicable, a lot of camaraderie there. So those two energies, as they're rising at the same time, can kind of even each other out. So that's a wonderful aspect of our inner journey forecast this week. And I also want to say, because there's not a lot of really complex transits happening this week, I want to actually honor a transit that is ending at this period of time. And that's there in the sky. There has been a transit of Uranus in a semi-square to Neptune. And that's been there for a while, I think over a year, and it's really ending now. It's ending now. And I just want to give an honor to that transit. And maybe we can skate the energies of this transit as it's on its way out. Maybe this week we can take advantage of it. Uranus and Neptune combination is one of the most dazzling of the archetypal combinations. Neptune has to do with realities, subtle realities, spiritual realities, realities that have a unifying quality to them, an imaginative quality to them, an archetypal quality to them, the collective unconscious, the archetypal sea of imagery and imagination, unitive consciousness, unitive realities. These are all Neptunian. And Uranus is the one that makes things new and exciting. And always whenever it comes into an alignment with another planet, it brings out new angles, new exciting angles on that. And so it's a great combination for inner journeys and spiritual kind of eureka moments. And we can see it actually in the recent release of WandaVision, which is a series that had a season that went through the winter, basically, of 2021. And that was when that transit was very active. And it has to do with these people that are in a kind of a sitcom world. They're Marvel superheroes, but they're living in a 1950s sitcom. And they're sensing that there's more to reality. There's a deeper, more nuanced reality happening here. And that's kind of the quality of the Uranus Neptune. There's a sense of, wow, there's some new angles on reality here that can be accessed. When Uranus and Neptune were in conjunction, big conjunction in the entire 1990s, that's when the Truman Show came out. And the Truman Show is that exact example of somebody who's trapped in a what they think reality is, which is a show. It's just like WandaVision. But then at a certain point, they bump up against the limits of that show and they realize there's a reality outside of that. So, you know, there's roles that we play, and sometimes life can feel like a fixed reality, but the Uranus Neptune gives a sense of escaping to another side, a new perspective, a new angle that allows for a much more expansive, unitive experience of reality. That transit, it's on its way out, a beautiful transit. We want to take advantage of it and take advantage of its rewarding side. Its challenging side has also been here with us, and that challenging side is also fading out. Challenging side is that the reality principle gets disrupted. Uranus is also the disruptor by unclear senses of reality. That's Neptunian, delusional realities. So we've seen a lot of that as well in the media all through 2020, is that aspect was very active then. So that is also fading out, that intensity there. So again, they all have challenges, they all have rewards. And let's be on the rewarding side with our archetypal mindfulness. And I want to announce to everybody here that there is a course that I'll be teaching. It's actually a free webinar. I'm going to be teaching a free webinar March 28th. That is a how to plan your next inner journey using archetypal astrology. So we're going to sit down. It's an hour long webinar so that you can actually plan your next inner journey. And you can actually sit down with me, with us on the webinar, and find the best times, the optimal times, the beautiful times, so that you can experience inner journey and understand the energies that are coming up in that inner journey, anticipate, welcome, integrate after the fact. It's very exciting. It's really fun. And so I welcome you to join that. You can join by clicking the link below, absolutely free. Thank you so much for being with me here today, and have a great week of inner journeys. Yay!